The best time to get a credit card is before you need one. But it can be scary to pick and handle that first card, even more so when you're an international in the US. We hope to make that a little easier on you by talking about the 5 best beginner credit cards and how you can use them to build your credit history from scratch. So let's get started.
Hey everyone, welcome to our channel. We're jumping straight into the topic for today. Credit cards. They can help us build credit easily, but can just as easily lead us into debt. No matter how much we love them or hate them, credit cards are an inevitable part of our financial life.
Let me tell you a story. When I first moved to the US, I had absolutely no idea how important credit was. A year later, I graduated from my master's program, super excited to finally buy a car for myself. At that point, I didn't have a credit card or any other loan in the US. So I basically had a non-existent credit score. Because of this, I had to finance my car for a 7.5% interest rate, which is more than double what you'd pay with even an average credit score. If I had known about this back then, I would have saved many hundreds of dollars in interest.
This was one of the motivations behind creating this channel, because we didn't want others to face the same problems we did when trying to navigate the complex financial space in the US. We try to share tips, experiences, and knowledge to help make smart money choices. So if that's something that interests you, consider clicking the red subscribe button and the notification bell next to it so that you get notified every time we release a new video.
One of the best ways to start building your credit is through credit cards. So how do you go about choosing a good starter card? Well, here are some things to consider. The first is the annual fee. Try to choose a card with a $0 annual fee, because this way you can keep the card open for a long time at no cost. This increases the average age of your accounts and has a positive effect on your credit score.
The second is rewards. There isn't a single best credit card option out there because people value things differently and have different spending habits. So if you're someone who eats at restaurants often, drives around a lot, or travels regularly, then you may want to get a card that has rewards for those specific categories.
The third is customer service. Back in 2019, I remember finding a fraudulent charge on my card. Someone had gotten access to my details and had bought something at a Target in Wisconsin, if I remember correctly. I just had to call up Discover Bank and they had it sorted in a matter of minutes. It's only in these situations that you understand how priceless good customer service is.
Now, if you were paying attention, you would have noticed that we did not mention a very big factor, interest rates. That's because they shouldn't matter. You should be paying off your statement balance in full every single month. Never get sucked into the trap of paying interest on credit cards because you treated it like free money. If you don't trust your discipline or you think you'll go out of control with the spending, then just don't get one. It's as simple as that.
If you watched our last video, you're probably aware of just how important it is to build a credit from early on. Credit cards become a great tool for this when used responsibly. So here are our top 5 picks for beginner credit cards in no particular order. We'll have links in the description for each of them.
First up, we have the Discover It card. There are 2 versions of this. You can either get the student version or the regular Discover It cashback. They're both quite similar, except the student version will give you a $20 annual statement credit for good grades and has less friendly interest rates.
With Discover, you can earn cashback in 2 ways. You get a 5% cashback for specific categories every quarter up to $1,500. For July to September, these categories are restaurants and PayPal. So every time you eat at a restaurant or use the PayPal app, you get 5% of that amount back as cash reward, which can be used at any point. The downsides of this card are that you have to activate these categories every quarter and that Discover isn't accepted at some places.
The other way to get cashback is just the 1% that you get as cash rewards on all of your purchases, regardless of the category. There's no limit here, so go crazy. Actually, don't. That's terrible advice. Do not go crazy. Discover will automatically match all of your cashback at the end of the first year without a maximum cap. This is personally one of my favorites, and fun fact, it was the first credit card that I got in the US.
Up next is the Deserve Edu MasterCard. From comments on our previous videos, we know that we have quite a few international student viewers who are either already in the US or are thinking about coming here. This card is designed specifically for you folks because a social security number is not required. You only need a passport, a US bank account, and a student visa. It's intended to help those without a credit history to start building a reliable credit score.
This card has 1% unlimited cashback on all purchases, and it also gives you 1 year of Amazon Prime student membership if you spend $500 in the first 3 billing cycles. There's no annual fee, and there's also no international transaction fee, so you can use this card when you travel back home as well. The only downside is that it has a very high APR of 18.74%, which is way above the average for a student credit card.
Third on the list is the Chase Freedom Unlimited. This card has a great intro offer where you can get a $200 bonus after spending $500 in your first 3 months. You also get 1.5% cashback on all purchases and get a 0% APR for the first 15 months. More recently, they also introduced 5% cashback on all grocery store purchases up to $12,000 in your first year. There's no annual fee for this card either.
The reason we love this card is because you can enter the Chase ecosystem and get two other cards that complete the Chase trifecta, which would give you maximum rewards and benefits. You can transfer the points from this card to more premium cards like the Sapphire Preferred or Reserve for more value. But that's a topic for a whole other video.
Up next is the Capital One Platinum Secured. This is a secured credit card, which means that if you have very little credit history, you pay a few hundred dollars upfront and then get offered a credit line for that amount. Discover has a version of this, which is probably the best secured credit card out there. But since we already talked about it, we're going to talk about the second best secured credit card, which is this Capital One.
There's no annual fee, no foreign transaction fee. You can pick a monthly due date that works best for you. And there's fraud coverage if your card is lost or stolen. You can generally get access to a higher credit line if you make the first 6 monthly payments on time. The disadvantage of having this card is that there are no rewards and it has a very high APR of 26.99%. So use this card to build your credit and eventually upgrade to an unsecured card with better benefits.
The last one we have for you is the American Express Blue Cash Everyday Card. With this card, you can earn 3% cashback on US supermarket purchases up to $6,000 per year. You also get 2% cashback at US gas stations and department stores, and 1% cashback on all other purchases. Their introductory offer is $150 in statement credit after spending $1,000 in your first 3 months. It also offers a 0% APR for the first 15 months.
Amex has a special program called Planet, where for select purchases above $100, you can choose to split those payments into installments with no interest.
The cons of this card are that American Express isn't accepted as widely as Visa or MasterCard, and that this card requires a higher credit score to get approved. So I would treat this as more of a premium starter card.
If you're still confused about exactly what to do with this information, let me try and bring it all together for you. Here's what I would suggest doing while first moving to the US to build your credit from scratch. Start off by applying for a basic card like the Deserve Edu if you don't have an SSN, or a secured one like Capital One if you can get approved for it. Use it responsibly by putting a few purchases on it every month and paying off the statement balance in full. After about 6 to 12 months of doing this, apply for an unsecured card like the Discover It or the Chase Freedom card. You'll get better benefits and can continue to build your credit with responsible usage. Another 6 to 12 months after that, you'll have a credit score good enough to qualify for some of the premium cards, like the Chase Sapphire or some higher-end American Express cards.
Again, I just want to reiterate how important it is to control credit card spending. Basically, treat it like a debit card with benefits. For example, if you put a $50 purchase on your credit card, and your bank account has $1,000 in it, pretend like you only have $950 left. This way you build good discipline and don't spend more than what you can afford. Remember, building credit is a gradual and steady process. By sticking to the basics of keeping your utilization low and paying off your balances in full, you'll be well on your way to a 750 plus credit score.
Alright, that's a wrap. Remember, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. We're so close to that 1,000 subscriber mark and would really appreciate your help. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.